So now this is your video on vacuum tube cooling and heat sinking, and this is episode 2, where we look at what a shield does to your vacuum tube if you add a grounded shield around your tube. So for example, like here, so around this tube I have the copper shield around it, but you see it's not grounded. So if I were to solder a wire on it and ground it to the chassis, then that would do something very interesting to the vacuum tube. What would it do? So when you look at the pentode, this is a representation of a pentode. We have a cathode here. So this is close to 0 volts potential, 0 volts DC. Of course, if it's a fixed bias, then it might be sitting exactly at zero. If it's cathode bias, it means that you use a resistor or battery or LED strings or another supply, whatever here, to generate a few volts bias, usually for signal tubes between something between 2 volts and 6 volts, something like that. But it's very close to your ground. And now, how your pentode looks on the inside. You have the cathode that's very close to it, and then this is your input grid. So that's the grid that receives the signal for the music. And then we have here, that's our screen or grid number 2, and that actually, how you connect it will tell you how your pentode will behave. If you connect this to the ultralinear tap of your output transformer, in case if it's a power tube like an AL34, then it will be an ultralinear connection. If you connect it to your plate, so this connected to there, then you will turn it into a triode, and it's a low gain triode. And if you connect it to the grid, which is the input grid, if you connect these two together, you will also turn it into a triode, but it will be a high gain triode. So it means that it will amplify the signal many times, over like 100 times, but it will have very high plate impedance. Anyway, that's a subject and topic for next time. So now let's just say that the second grid is responsible on the operation mode of your tube, how it is working. And then we have a suppressor grid, that's grid number 3, which is usually internally connected to the cathode. And the role of that is that when the electrons travel through your structure here and they go from cathode to the plate, then there's like so much energy and so high energy that they travel, depending on your tube, somewhere between 100 volts, that's not that much, but there are tubes where you have like 1000 volts accelerating the electrons, and when they hit, they bombard the plate, then they bounce back. And the electrons that bounce back, if they hit the grid number 2, that will alter the characteristics of the tube. So it will affect how it's amplifying the signal. So that's why they created this extra grid here that's grounded to the cathode, so that it catches and collects those stray electrons that get bounced off from the plate, and they do not affect the driving characteristics of the tube. So why did I explain this to you? Because if you add an extra layer of metal around your tube, and of course, right, copper is a very nice conductive metal, then you are effectively adding another electrode on the other side of the plate. And if you do not ground it, let it move and let it statically adjust to the plate's static voltage, then it does not affect operation that much. However, if we ground it, let's say Now we are grounding it to ground to the chassis. Then basically you are creating this, so then you make it work as an extra grid. If it's not grounded, then it's almost invisible for the plate, and then we are not adding any extra electrodes. But the moment we ground it, we have this situation. And inside the vacuum tube, the suppressor grid is a very loose structure. So if you have opened up a vacuum tube, then you see that these are hairlines and there's barely any turns of them. And now we are adding a suppressor structure that's solid. So it's a much more massive structure than the internal suppressor of the vacuum tube, and it's going to affect your sound quite a bit. And look at that, at 0 volts, which is actually, if you look at that, the cathode is sitting maybe, let's say, at 3 volts DC. If you connect it to the ground, then you are connecting it to 0 volts DC, so it's even below the cathode's voltage, so it's going to impact the plate quite a bit. So this is our plate, and now we are adding voltage, a field around it, so that if you look at the vacuum tube, let's say we are looking at the tube from up. So if you are looking it from the top, then on the inside you have the cathode, and then you have the grids around it, first grid, second grid, and third grid. I just draw it like this because it's barely anything. And then you have the plate structure around it. And then you have the glass of the vacuum tube, and now we are adding another electrode around the glass. So when you have these electrodes, all of them build up a magnetic field that surrounds that electrode. And these surrounding magnetic fields, to be strong, you need to allow them to expand. And the most important part of that is you need the plate to build up its magnetic field, because that's several hundred volts different than the cathode. So its magnetic field really extends out. And when we add something that's at zero potential, that really restricts the magnetic field and does and forces it to collapse. And you will hear it in the sound as well, as decrease the dynamics and decrease the top end frequency because of the extra capacitance that layer represents. So basically you are adding capacitance when you add the shield and ground it. So yes, if you have a high enough resolving amplifier and system, then when you add the grounded tube cooler shield, then you will notice an impact in the weakening of dynamics, weakening of top end. And it will sound a little bit more closed in, as if the space is, the imaging space is collapsing a little bit. However, you will also gain an extra layer of clarity if your place is subject to a lot of EMI, a lot of radio frequency radiation, then it helps to filter those out. So I would say that try these things out on your amplifiers and see for yourself what works and what doesn't work for you, because depending on your area where you live, the benefits of the grounded tube cooler shield might outweigh the negative effects of added capacitance. I would say that always apply caution when you do that. So if you want to add cooling strips to your tubes, first of all, turn the amplifier off, unplug it, and do not handle the tubes when the amplifier is under power, especially in the case of these, if you have plate cap tubes that have caps on the top. So this means that the high voltage is running through these wires onto the top of the tubes. So they have, these have like a 600 watts right here. So you don't want to mess with a copper conductive material close to that, because while the amp is on, because first of all it's way too hot to handle, and second you will just kill yourself maybe accidentally. And second thing, if you add the strips, then remove the tubes, and when you have the tube in your hand, then you can put those strips on them. But for these guys, make sure that you remove the tube completely. So you remove the plate cap and then remove the tube. Do not leave the plate cap on and then try to add the strip, because even though you turn the amp off, there will be still some voltage on in the plate cap. So make sure that when you handle the plate cap, do not touch the metal part on the inside. And of course, for these tubes with plate caps, do not extend the copper element beyond this point. So leave a healthy distance between plate cap and your cooler, because otherwise, if you make it close here, you will short it. So the static charge will just jump. You will form and your plates will be charged up to 600 volts. And then if you accidentally just touch them, you will get a little or maybe a big zap from them. And if the gap is really small, then they can constantly regain their charge. And if you are grounded, so with one hand you are touching the chassis and another one you touch here, and there is no distance between these two, you can very well kill yourself. So that's a warning. Don't do stupid things. Observe safety rules and precautions. And these are all suggestions. So take it under caution and advisement. And if you do something stupid, something that I didn't tell you, and for example, you are standing in a puddle of water and then touching your amps and you zap yourself, this channel is not responsible, not liable for those actions. Unfortunately, I have to say these things for you. For some of you, this might sound offensive that I think that so low of your intelligence. Not at all. I know that most of my viewers are really smart and you know very well the dangers of high voltage of vacuum tubes. But there's always a section of people on YouTube who are trying to go for Darwin Awards, and we have to tell these things to discourage these people from these world record attempts, because if they do that, they often try to go and sue the channel and make it responsible. Oh, my son heard that tip on your channel, that's why he killed himself. No, he was a bloody idiot, that's why he killed himself. But we have to make sure that such behavior is not encouraged in any way by these video contents. So I'm telling everyone, always be very cautious when you are dealing with high voltages, when we are dealing with tube amplifiers. If you observe safety precautions and rules, I never had any of my friends had any serious accidents, no one got injured, no amplifier caught on fire, no property damage whatsoever. So if you are a reasonably educated person, so I mean you use your common sense, then you will not run into problems. Provided you have your common sense and your education, so do not do things that you don't feel comfortable with. If you hear advice from me and you do and you are okay with it and you have experience based it, you can try those things. If not, then hook up with a friend of yours in your area and have him or her help you to show and demonstrate these safety rules and advices, and you will have a fantastic time with this audio equipment. So thank you for tuning in. Be safe, stay safe, bye bye.